Well, this week we finally have government employees back to work after a long furlough period.
The government shutdown was a historic 35-day shutdown. We don't care about the politics. What we do care about is that Mainers needed help, and Mainers helped Mainers out.
Let's talk about it. WhaZ NewZ. That people are back to work, but there's sort of this 3-week mark that we have to get through before we know for sure whether things are back to normal or not.
Lots of government workers are still waiting to get their back pay. Contracted government employees will be on the bottom of the list to get paid, so there are still plenty of people out there who are going without pay at this point. Lots of local businesses have come forward to really help out these people that can't quite help themselves yet. And you're talking about a bunch of people that aren't used to not being able to help themselves.
That's true.
And I think it's hard for people to reach out and ask for help sometimes. TSA workers, for example, you had to go to work even though you knew you weren't getting paid.
Right.
So it's been really cool that a bunch of the businesses in the area have offered help to these people without even having to be asked.
We wanted to give a shout out to the organizations and businesses that helped out, but also to the furloughed workers who've gone through a month of uncertainty.
Heard all sorts of stories online about people like TSA agents finding gift cards in the bin, food and things like that.
Let's take a look at some area businesses that stepped up and wanted to help out those furloughed workers that we have living here in the Bangor area. Some of the organizations that you would expect to step up were obviously there. Good Shepherd Food Bank, they came out and said, you know, hey, we've got places to put food and we got a place for people to come pick up food. So big thank you to them as always. United Way of Eastern Maine, Health Equity Alliance, the Salvation Army, as well as FedCap. These are organizations that help those in need anyway, but always a big thank you to those guys.
But then we saw other local businesses too. The Bangor Symphony Orchestra was offering free tickets to shows to furloughed government workers. Moe's Barbecue was one of the first people in the Bangor area to kind of just run out there and throw it out that they wanted to help.
The Bangor Y, they offered free memberships to government employees who are not being paid during the time.
You can get fit while you're furloughed. Main Trailer in Hamden was offering free trailer registrations.
And lots of banks came forward to try to help out as well. Also a big thank you to Bangor people. I think we all have this sense of community that no matter how you feel about political aspects of this whole situation, either way, we have care and concern for those that were directly affected. If it wasn't for you guys, then the pantries wouldn't have food. Gift cards, those wouldn't have happened.
When you just have people out there in your community that have been deprived of their paycheck for something that has nothing to do with them.
Right.
I think that sort of becomes like a sort of call to arms for people, like, let's help these folks out, because this isn't their fault.
It's the spirit of Bangor, it's the spirit of Maine.
Give me five.
Give me five!
Normally we tell you to stay cool, Bangor, but this week you guys were just cool.
Kind and caring and friggin' cool. Alright, well, we'll catch up with you next week. I think we're gonna do a little Valentine's special.
Oh, we got something planned.
Alright, stay cool, Bangor.
Wicked cool.